Please hit the bell along with the subscribes button as you listen. Syd Nomis was born on the 15th of November 1941 and died on the 16th of June 2018. He was a South African National Rugby Union player who until 2001 held the record for most consecutive matches 25 played for the Springboks. Nomis is best remembered for tries that he scored against France in 1968 and the All Blacks in 1970. Along with Ockie Jeffin, Nomis is considered one of the greatest Jewish rugby players of all time, and is a member of the International Jewish Sports Hall of Fame. He was inducted in 1999. Nomis played club rugby for Wanderers in Johannesburg, in a league that included Iscor, Diggers, Vanderbijlpark and police teams. Nomis recalled in a 2008 interview with Dave Gemmell how hard and dirty the game had been. He revealed that while playing club rugby he also occasionally received slurs, with opponents calling him a Boer Jood, Afrikaans for bloody Jew. Nomis remembered injuring one such a player to the extent that he had to be carried off the field. If you played rugby then, that was how it was played, there was no other way. Club rugby was almost harder than international rugby. Nomis said that he only experienced anti-Semitism at club level. But after the game we would have a beer together and we would be big mates. And national rugby official Danny Craven at the time believed that selecting a Jew and a policeman brought luck to the Springbok team. In 1961, and again in 1962, Nomis was selected to play for the Quaggers, an invitational South African team styled after the Barbarians. He spent his provincial rugby career at the Transvaal Rugby Union, for whom he was first selected in 1963. Nomis played 29 uncapped matches on tours with national sides, including the 1965 Springbok tours to Australia and New Zealand, and the 1966 Gazelles outing to Argentina, which included a game against Chile. In 1965 Nomis was selected at centre alongside John Gainsford for the side that left for Australia under coach Johan Klaassen. The Melbourne newspaper, The Age, was impressed with Nomis and Gainsford's incredible acceleration during a 52-6 Springbok victory over Victoria at Olympic Park's No. 2 Oval on 12 June. Apart from a solitary win against New Zealand, the Springboks lost 5 out of 6 test matches on the rain-sodden tour, and was judged by the New Zealand Herald's Terry McLean to be the worst South African team to face the All Blacks. Matters were not helped by South African Prime Minister H.F. Verwoerd's announcement during the tour that Maoris would not be allowed to play in South Africa if selected for the 1967 All Black tour to that country. In 1966 Nomis was chosen to represent a South African under-25 side known as the Gazelles on their tour to Argentina. He did not play in the two tests against the Argentinian national side, but did score 5 tries in 7 other matches, including 2 against Cordoba on 24 August. In addition to his uncapped matches, Nomis was capped 25 times for a total of 54 appearances in the green and gold. Although selected 22 times for the Springboks on the wing, Nomis' first 3 test appearances were at centre. For his debut test against France at Newlands Stadium in Cape Town on 12 August 1967, Nomis was chosen at centre, a position he retained for 3 consecutive tests. The French tour was organised by Danny Craven, then president of the South African Rugby Union, to replace a New Zealand tour, which had been cancelled by New Zealand after the South African government refused to allow Maori members entry. The French were Five Nations champions that year. Nomis replaced centre John Gainsford, who had occupied the position for 33 tests between 1960 and 1967. Gainsford sent him a telegram that read, "Like I'm sad man, like I'm glad man, play well. John Gainsford." Nomis scored one of his six test career tries against the French on a cold 16 November 1968 at the Stade Olympique Yves Dumanoir in Colombes, northwest of Paris. Before 24,000 spectators, Nomis helped his team beat France 16-11 by virtually crawling across the try line to score. The try came after Manet Giroux was tackled and Nomis kicked the loose ball into the in-goal area. As he ran to dot down, his legs cramped and he fell down. After repeatedly falling down from cramp and getting up again, he managed to score the try. He later discovered that in commentary on the match, South African radio broadcaster Charles Fortune had credited Giroux with the try. On 8 August 1970 at Newlands in the second test against the touring side, Nomis was felled by All Black fullback Fergie McCormick. Nomis had kicked the ball over McCormick's head and tried to run around him. McCormick spun around and hit Nomis in the mouth with his elbow, knocking out two teeth and loosening several others. Referee Winan Malan, a dentist, straightened Nomis' teeth on the field. Although he had lost consciousness briefly, Nomis stayed on to finish the game with a bleeding mouth. He later described the test as the dirtiest game of rugby I have ever seen or been involved in. The Johannesburg newspaper The Sunday Times claimed that film of the clash showed it to be accidental. Nomis still dismisses the claim, pointing out that in McCormick's autobiography the fullback said that he would have done anything to stop Nomis. "McCormick was one of the dirtiest rugby players I ever played against," Nomis said in a 2008 interview. He died at 76 years old.